phone records. Miraculously, the idea took fire. The people of Wexford were mad enough to start an operatic festival in 1951 and sane enough to make it work ever since. The southeast tip of Ireland is a good place to listen to radio, so they listened, especially to France and Italy. They picked up good young singers before they got too expensive, mixed them with others, they cast their nets wide, Wexford was a fishing port, and they cast their operas cannily. No point in doing the operas every house does, try the lesser-known ones. And so Mirella Freni, for example, came here to sing I Puritani in 1962, before she was quite the international star that she became later on. And so it has gone on here at Wexford, usually three operas a year, one for the heart, one for the head, and one for fun. And fun is important if you want a really festive festival. The local people have raised money. More than that, they've been volunteer workers front and backstage. In the beginning, the director was the local anaesthetist, Dr. Tom Walsh. And they used to say that Tom put the town to sleep for 49 weeks of the year and then woke them up from the other three. Some of the operas turned out to be lame duck, some healthy but neglected. Things like Humperdinck's other opera, forgotten Bellini, Donizetti and Rossini, now back in favour, partly due to Wexford. Lovely French operas, never done at the Met or Covent Garden. Or The Devil and Kate. Or you can call it Kate and the Devil. Written by Dvorak just at the end of Queen Victoria's reign. And I think Her Majesty would not have been amused. We're all used to performances in which we have to imagine that the large, mature soprano is actually 17 and sylph-like. Well, Kate is something else. From the very start, Dvorak meant her to be a big girl and rather clumsy, too. Another thing Her Majesty would surely have disapproved of is that hell proves to be rather jolly, and the devil of the title is only a minor diabolical. But Kate does go to hell. At a dance, she is a wallflower, and having no partners, she says in desperation that if the devil himself asked her to dance, she would, and sure enough, well, I won't spoil it for you by telling you too much, but I must say there are two plots in this opera for the price of one. And the second plot is about a Bohemian shepherd, about to be fired by his tyrannical boss, the princess. Not only fired, he's told to go to hell, which he promptly does. And that's what all the action is about. Dvorak spent half his life writing popular symphonies, Slavonic dances, quartets and oratorios, but he yearned for success with opera. The Devil and Kate has all the ingredients for a popular opera. It's got good tunes, comedy, plenty of Czech-flavoured dances. So, Act One, Saturday night in old Bohemia, come dancing in a feudal village. But Jirka has been busy with the bottle, and he now has to go to work. Now, the nasties in this opera are the princess, you won't see her until Act Three, and her steward, Jirka's immediate boss, well, you won't see him at all. Jirka leaves with his little band of musicians, but not before the arrival of Kate and her mother. The lads remind Jirka that Kate is on the lookout for a husband. Oh, no, he says. She only ever stops talking to stuff herself with food. So, exit Jirka, singing plaintive song. Dancing, but nobody wants to trip the heavy fantastic with Kate. And that's when she makes her unguarded remark about dancing with the devil himself. Promptly, enters one of old Nick's men, pricking up his not very wicked ears. He's just passing to find out if the princess and her steward are quite ready for hell. He's the man in hunter's clothing, by name Marbuel, by voice baritone. The chorus assists him in his inquiries. So Marbuel dances with Kate, and then back comes Jirka, having got the sack, partly for being late, partly because he brought all those musicians with him. I mean, you know he must be, that steward, he must be nasty because he doesn't like music. Kate and Marbuel disappear through a hole in the floor. Jirka offers to go down and bring Kate back. After all, what's he got to lose? And as he has been told to go to hell, for once he will oblige.
Thank you. craving, thus of course my noble lord, noble lord, noble lord. Friends who know the steward, he would throw me out. He would, no, I really would.
For that steward is
three sheep I am in. Next to Thank you. Thank you. I to do without you?
Well, now, mother, stop your crying. I owe her to them.
Now we know the answer. We asked, were you satisfied with your detergent before we introduced this?
The first detergent to remove stains and odors. Hundreds of thousands of you bought it, tried it, and you keep on buying it.
Proof that Radion's unique formula works.
Not just in getting out the toughest dirt and stains, even at low temperatures, but actually removing the odors other detergents merely cover up.
The proof's in the performance.
The heat of the iron will tell you. New Radion removes the odors as well as the stains.
Here comes the lilt man.
Lilt.
Here comes the lilt man.
Lilt.
Lilt. With a totally tropical taste.
Pineapple and grapefruit.
Lilt.
And the sun is bright.
Lilt.
And the sand is white.
Lilt.
With a totally tropical taste. With a totally tropical taste.
Lilt.
Yup! 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 Yup!
Yes! 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 Yes!
Don't say yes.
Say yup!
When it's time for
break, break, break,
the Cadbury's
snack,
snack,
snack.
Choose it for the chocolate.
Cadbury's snack, snack, snack.
Choose it for the chocolate.
I work to keep my body in condition. Keeping my hair in condition shouldn't be so hard. I may need a conditioner, but I don't need the hassle. I want to just wash and go. I've got all I need, right here. It's new Vidal Sassoon Wash and Go. It's shampoo plus complete conditioner in one bottle. My hair's clean, feels good, and it does what I want it to. My hair looks great, and all I do is wash and go.
New Vidal Sassoon Wash and Go, shampoo plus complete conditioner.
Only natural gas central heating has something to make a song and dance about.
50-50 cash back, 50-50 cash back, it's half price plus.
Change over to Natural Gas Central Heating now. Get half price gas for the next 3 years.
50-50 cash back, 50-50 cash back.
Sealink once again sponsor the Wexford Opera Festival because we love the high seas.
The second act of The Devil and Kate is absolute hell. Well, maybe not so absolute, because it seems to be quite a jolly place. There's a group of devils singing the praise of gold, the surest passport to the great underground. Two things stand out. One, that orgies down in hell are all rather innocent. And the other is that Kate soon outstays her welcome. So let's join the audience again in the Theatre Royal Wexford for an act of jolly hell.
Thank you.
will have cursed them both more than a thousand times. My friend has fallen. It was
Give me what you promised.
Kate, don't come now.
they want to teach her. Give her a shot. But a horror, how I now regret it. She must be fair, oh, what horror, I regret it. It has cost me very dearly.
Take her back again. Oh,
Thank you. Important thing to get right when you're painting is your paint. You want a top quality paint that's not too expensive and goes on easily, covers well and lasts beautifully. Which is why you're right to insist on Crown. Don't just paint it, Crown it.
250 jukebox stereo radio cassette players must be won. Collect any five wrappers from Mars, Twix, Marathon, Maltesers or Bounty and pick up an entry form from your local store.
Give it a look. If you won't stop smoking for yourself, do it for your kids. Smoking is dangerous and disgusting. Stop it now.
Deodorant body spray for men. Lynx is musk, amber, spice, and now new oriental. Lynx, because first impressions last.
5413.
Capital 67 was correct. Report ready for departure.
The Capital Airline Emirates flight is now in service. Confirmed.
Twisting down with graphic gel spray from Garnier. The hair holds up, no buildups. Cool feet with graphic mousse fixe. Volume control, no stickiness. Rock and roll with graphic power gel. Rock steady hair, no flakiness. Strong on style, kind on hair. New graphic from Garnier.
Dove Liquid's great. I never thought it'd be so easy to get my white so white.
Well, you were so impressed with Dove Liquid, you appeared in a commercial, Val. So why did you stop using it?
Well, a few weeks ago, I was asked to try this new Dove Liquid. My boy Alfie drives me mad with his scrambling bike. He gets this whole gungy stuff all over his hands. Wouldn't enter his head to use a cloth. This new Dove Liquid's great. Just rub a bit in on the really rotten marks. It's hard to believe that anything Alfie wears will ever get white again. But it did. My whites were pretty good before, but now they really stand out, do you know what I mean?
So, Val, what's the chance of you swapping back to your old liquid?
No chance. I'm sticking with new Dove Liquid. It's alpha-proof.
New Dove Liquid shifts greasy dirt, gives you even whiter whites, and you'll like the price.
In Act 3, the boss princess lady finally appears, and she's rather more sympathetic than you'd expect. And immediately she has the most substantial aria in the whole opera, singing of the sadness that has overtaken her castle ever since she heard the voice of fate. She calls for her chambermaid and pours out to her her regrets and remorse. The chambermaid offers some comfort, telling how the brave shepherd Yerka saved the steward from being dragged down to hell. Perhaps he might do the same for the princess. Incidentally, Kathleen Tynan, the soprano who plays the chambermaid, is a Wexford girl. So, the plot all works out nicely. The princess makes Yerka her chief minister. Yerka tells the assembled company that he has their interest at heart. just like any politician, and the opera ends with suitable festivities, leaving the audience wondering somewhat what the future will bring. Will Kate find a man? And will Jirka do more than administrate? Watch this space.
Thank you. meantime, princess, you must leave me for a while alone here. I will do what necessary, making sure that all is ready. I will do what necessary, then I'll send for you to
I'm
Not a word of hell I had to lose.
Next Saturday evening here on Network 2, we bring you another opera recorded at the 1988 Wexford Festival, Gazzaniga's Don Giovanni. That's at 10 p.m. Saturday next.